Hi guys, in this series we will discuss about 5G NR physical layer concepts. Here NR stands for new radio, which is the name given to upcoming 5G technology, like LTE was given to 4G. As a first installment of this series, we are presenting this first chapter, which will cover the basic concepts like numerology, frame structure, and we will also touch upon the frequency ranges. So let's proceed. Talking of numerology, as we know, LTE has single subcarrier spacing equal to 15 kHz. But here in NR, we have multiple numerologies, and those are represented by Greek letter mu. Here, this SES means subcarrier spacing. So 15 kHz will be the smallest subcarrier spacing, and as we go down the table, we have wider subcarrier spacings. NR has subcarrier spacing ranging from 15 to 240 kHz. And as seen in the table, extended cyclic prefix is supported only in 60 kHz case. So LTE has single possible value of subcarrier spacing, while NR has multiple values. Therefore, in summary, idea of numerology is to have representation of various possible subcarrier spacings in NR. Now let's discuss the motivation behind having multiple subcarrier spacing in NR. NR can support wide range of deployment scenarios, ranging from sub 1 GHz to millimeter wave applications. CP length reduces with cell size. Smaller cell size have low delay spread, which means we can use lower length cyclic prefix to reduce overhead on system. And as we know, cyclic prefix is a part of symbol itself. And as symbol length and subcarrier spacing are inversely proportional to each other, therefore, with wider subcarrier spacing are more suitable for deployment with smaller cell size. Yeah, so talking of impact of subcarrier spacing on phase noise. So the point is, phase noise increases with local oscillator frequency, but it reduces with subcarrier spacing. So as we go higher in terms of local oscillator frequency, phase noise increases, but as we go on wider subcarrier spacings, phase noise reduces. So therefore, if you want to operate in higher frequency ranges, we should use wider subcarrier spacing to mitigate phase noise. In NR, scheduling happens on slot level, and also as we know that subcarrier spacing is inversely proportional to slot duration. As we told that in NR, scheduling happens on slot level, therefore latency of the system is also determined by slot durations. So lower slot duration or higher subcarrier spacing implies low latency. But in cases where delay spread is high, CP length should also be higher. So in that case, we should be using narrow subcarrier spacing like 15 or 30 kHz. Now you might be thinking that in these cases, like in lower subcarrier spacing cases, like in higher delay spread cases, we will not have wider subcarrier advantages, or we will not be having advantages which are related with wider subcarrier spacing. So for that, 3GPP allowed to have extended cyclic prefix in 60 kHz case. So we can have in 60 kHz subcarrier spacing case, we can have extended cyclic prefix. Extended CP we can have, as we saw earlier in the numerology table. As there is a famous saying that nothing comes for free. So till now, we have discussed all the advantages of multiple numerologies or multiple subcarrier spacings. But one minus point with multiple subcarrier spacing in NR is that the multiple numerologies create inter-numerology interference. There are some algorithms that can mitigate or reduce the impact of this, but this minus point or disadvantage is there related with the usage of multiple numerologies.
Yeah, so talking of inter-numerology interference, here the spectral confinement is important to reduce inter-numerology interference as well as out-of-band emissions. Also, the spectral roll-off for an OFDM waveform becomes steeper as subcarrier spacing decreases. We will show the PSDs of two equal bandwidth OFDM signals with subcarrier spacing of 15 kHz and 40 to 480 kHz. Here we can see that spectral roll-off for 15 kHz waveform is relatively more steeper than 480 kHz waveform. You can see here in this the difference between this black colored waveform, which is for 480 kHz, and this red waveform, which is for 15 kHz. So this is again a plus point for narrower subcarrier spacing waveforms. Now coming to frame structure for NR, frame length here is 10 millisecond and subframe length is 1 millisecond, which means there are 10 subframes in one frame. Now coming to symbols and slots, number of OFDM symbol per slot are same for all subcarrier spacings and are equal to 14. Here you should focus on this highlighted point that number of symbols per slot are fixed or same for all subcarrier spacings. As you can see in the table, that for all numerologies, number of symbols in a slot are equal. So as number of symbols in a slot are same for all numerologies, which implies that slot length will reduce for higher subcarrier spacings. So as symbol length reduces with increasing subcarrier spacing, so that means slot length will also reduce with subcarrier spacing, as there are fixed number of symbols in a slot. So that means one subframe or frame can accommodate more number of slots as we go down this table. So as we can see here, that for 15 kHz subcarrier spacing, the number of slots in a frame are 10, which are same for LTE. And as we go down the table for other numerologies, number of slots in a frame are increasing. Now going in little bit detailed description of numerologies and slot length relation, here we can see that as subcarrier spacing increases, symbol duration decreases, which implies that slot duration decreases. Here we can see that for 15 kHz case, there are 10 number of slots. For 30 kHz case, there are 20 slots. And for 60 kHz case, there are 40 slots. So we can see in this picture that for whatever time duration one slot takes in 15 kHz case, in the same time duration, there will be two slots for 30 kHz case, and there will be four slots for 60 kHz case. And if you compare 30 kHz case and 60 kHz case, it is like for whatever time duration one slot occupies in 30 kHz case, there will be two slots for 60 kHz case. So to summarize this,
To summarize this, if we increase the subcarrier spacing, symbol duration will decrease, and hence slot duration will decrease, because there are fixed number of slots equal to 14. I beg your pardon. There are fixed number of symbols equal to 14 in one slot. Now, talking of frequency ranges for NR, Spec specifies two frequency ranges. Frequency range 1, also known as FR1, is from 0.45 to 6 GHz. Frequency range 2, FR2, is from 24.25 to 52.6 GHz. This is also known as millimeter waves. Currently, there is no NR spectrum between 6 to 24.25 GHz. And not all supported numerologies are relevant for all frequency bands. As we can see in this table, for frequency range 1, the supported numerologies are 15, 30, and 60 kHz. And for FR2, the supported numerologies are for 60 and 120 kHz. Guys, you can post your queries or questions, whatever you have, in the comment section. And you can share this video with your friends or colleagues. To increase the knowledge about 5G. Thanks.